after my sheep, says the Lord, and I will appoint a shepherd to pasture them, and I, the Lord, will be their God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And today is the feast of St. Bonaventure. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask that in the name of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters,
pray for me, the Lord. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that just as we celebrate the heavenly birthday of Bishop St. Bonaventure, we may benefit from his great learning and constantly imitate the ardor of his charity. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Lord of hosts says this: Woe to Assyria, the rod of my anger, the club brandished by me in my fury. I sent him against a godless nation. I gave him permission against a people that provokes me, to pillage and to plunder freely, and to stamp down like the mud in the streets. But he did not intend this. His heart did not plan it so. No, in his heart was to destroy, to go on cutting nations to pieces without limit. For he has said, by the strength of my own arm I have done this, and by my own intelligence, for understanding is mine. I have pushed back the frontiers of peoples and plundered their treasures. I have brought their inhabitants down to the dust. And if they were a bird's nest, my hand has seized the riches of the peoples. As people pick up deserted eggs, I have picked up the whole earth, with not a wing fluttering, not a beak opening, not a chirp. Does the axe claim more credit than the man who wields it? Or the saw more strength than the man who handles it? It would be like the cudgel controlling the man who raises it, or the club moving what is not made of wood. And so the Lord of hosts is going to send a wasting sickness on his stout warriors beneath his plenty. A burning will burn like a consuming fire. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord will not abandon his people.
The Lord will not abandon his people.
They crush your people, Lord. They afflict the ones you have chosen. They kill the widow and the stranger and murder the fatherless child.
The Lord will not abandon his people.
And they say, the Lord does not see. The God of Jacob pays no heed. Mark this, most senseless of people, fools, when will you understand? Response.
The Lord will not abandon his people.
Can he who made the ear not hear? Can he who formed the eye not see? Will he who trains nations not punish? Will he who teaches men not have knowledge response.
The Lord will not abandon his people.
The Lord will not abandon his people, nor forsake those who are his own. For judgment shall again be just, and all true hearts shall uphold it response.
The Lord will not abandon his people.
Gospel acclamation.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for revealing the mysteries of the kingdom to mere children.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus exclaimed, I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever, and revealing them to mere children. Yes, Father, for that is what it pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The example of St. Bonaventure is set before us today as we take up our daily class, and so we pray. We pray for that wisdom which comes from the Lord. May we treasure it in our minds and hearts. The Lord
has. Lord, Krishna, hear us.
The Lord enlightens St. Bonaventure with his heavenly truth. May he enlighten all those who are in darkness and in doubt. Lord, hear us.
Lord, Krishna, hear us.
May all those who are entrusted with teaching the young not grow weary of this task. May they pass on to others the precious gift of wisdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And we pray for all our own intentions. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all who have died, and remember those whose anniversaries are today: Joey McGrath, Kathleen Hackett, and Patrick MacDonald. May their souls of all the dead departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. Lord our God, may the lives of your holy ones inspire us to greater endeavor in the service of your people. May our lives be abundant in good works, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
And may the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favour, O Lord, we pray, on the offerings we set upon this sacred altar on the feast day of Blessed Bonaventure, that bestowing on us your pardon, our oblations may give honour to your name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with
your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Bonaventure you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of this holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord,
Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her venerable spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Bonaventure and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Damon, our Bishop, his assistant Bishop Michael, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow in the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and form of divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Just a reminder for the distribution of Holy Communion, I will begin to distribute on those in my left hand middle line, and when I have finished, I will then distribute communion to those sitting at my right hand middle line. You're asked to come up row by row, beginning from the front and working back up the middle line, and after receiving, return to your seat by the respective side aisles. Please do not return to your seat down the middle line. Meanwhile, Francis will begin to distribute at my right-hand side seats. Those sitting at that side are asked to leave the seat you are sitting in to your right and return to your seat by the left-hand side. And when he has finished then, he will distribute to those on my left-hand side. You're asked to leave the seat you're sitting in to the left and return to your seat by the right-hand side. So please remain patient and use the markings for social distancing. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. for those who cannot be here, the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you're already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Inspired
by the tongues of the light of you, O Virgin, Virgin, my mother. To you would have come before you and
stand,
sinful of sorrow. O Mother, the Lord incarnate, this night is not my
condition, but
it comes to
you as a man.
By the sacred mysteries, we humbly pray, O Lord, that following the example of Blessed Bonaventure, we may strive to profess what he believed and to practice what he taught through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just before the blessing, a reminder when you leave to exit by the side doors. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and